Hello Dev Grammars, I welcome you all to the brand new video. This video will be about git restore command. In this video, we will be learning about what are the different use cases of the git restore command. After that, I will be giving you one real life example, and I bet you after understanding this example, you will never forget about the git restore. And in the end, we will be seeing one example to take our understanding on the next level. So let's get started. So let's see the uses of the git restore on the first place. So as you can see, git restore command helps us to unstage or even discard the uncommitted local changes. Here uncommitted is the important word. So as you can see, there are particularly two use cases of the git restore. The first one being is that it is used to undo the effect of the git add. So as we all know that git add is used for staging the files, right? So to undo the effect of git add, we will be using git restore command. This is the first use case. And the another use case of the git restore will be to discard the local changes in our file which are uncommitted, of course. So this was about the uses of the git restore. So let's see one practical example with the help of which you will be getting the better perspective over git restore command. So for a moment, let's assume that your college has organized one hackathon and today is the award ceremony of that hackathon. So announcers announce that team number 30 is the winner. So the next task will be to make this team on stage. So as we have earlier discussed, git add command is used to make the files on stage. So in this case, git add team 30. But here is one catch. The real winners are team number 13. There was one mistake from the announcers. So announcers corrects their mistake by saying, "Sorry for the mistake, team 13 is the actual winner." In this case, our first task will be to unstage the wrong announced winners, which were the team number 30. So in this case, git restore will help us. So git restore, after that we have to pass in one flag called stage, and after that the file name. So git restore hyphen hyphen stage team 30. And our final task will be to make the real winners on stage. So we will be using git add team number 13. So this was about one real life example. Let's see one practical example where you can get more understanding on git restore. So here, as you can see, I am in my VS Code editor. Here I have created one index.html file which is empty file, and I have initialized the git repo. As you can see, if I just type in git status, so nothing to commit here. So our first task was that the announcers has announced the team 30's winner, right? So I'll just type in team 30 as a winners. So as you can see, if I just type in git status, so as you can see by this red color, this file is not on stage. So to take this file on stage, we will be using git add, after that the name of the particular file. So git add index.html. And if I just now check in the git status, so as you can see by this green color, this file is on stage. But there was one catch, right? If you remember, the real winners was not team 30, the real winners were team number 13, which is 13, right? So if we want to unstage this particular change, what we can use is that we will be using git restore. After that, we have to just pass in one flag called stage, and after that the name of the file. So as you can see, if I just type in git status by this red color, as you can see, this file is unstaged. So our one purpose is fulfilled, right? This was the one use case of the git restore, which was to undo the effect of git add. But there was again the second use case of the git restore, was to discard the local changes. So what was the local change that I have did in this file? I have added the line number 1, right? So what if I want to discard this particularly change? So this file is not on stage, but what if I want to remove this particular change which is not on stage? So for that particular part, I'll be using git restore. After that, I have to just pass in the name of the file without hyphen hyphen stage, which is a stage flag. So as you can see the change out here. If I just press in enter, as you can see, this local change has been discarded. So this was about the second use case of the git restore. So the final task was to make the actual winners, which was team 13 on stage. So as you can see, if I just type in git status, as you can see, this file is not on stage. For making this file on stage, we will be using git add, after that the name of the particular file. So as you can see, if I just check the status of the file, the real winners, which was team 13, are on stage. This was about the practical example. Here we have understood the two use cases of the git restore command with the help of this example. Alright, so that's it for this video. Thanks for watching and subscribe for more content like this. I'll see you in the next videos. Until then, keep learning and keep developing.